Hi students, welcome to Organic Chemistry Part 4 Question Answer Series. In this video, we will be discussing synthesis of alcohols appeared in different examinations. The methods of synthesis are hydroboration and oxidation, hydration of alkenes, reduction of carbonyl compounds, and synthesis of alcohols using Grignard reagent. Enjoy this video and let me know your questions. Have a nice time. The first question is, acid catalyzed hydration of alkenes except ethene leads to the formation of mixture of secondary and tertiary alcohols, mixture of primary and secondary alcohols, secondary or tertiary alcohol and primary alcohol. Which one is this? Let us see that. Now for that, let us take the reaction of hydration of alkenes. Now here, I have not taken ethene as an example. I have taken an asymmetrical alkenes, that is a propene. Propene has been taken here for hydration purpose. CH3, CH double bond, CH2. When this is made to react with dilute sulfuric acid, addition of water across the double bond, CC double bond takes place. So this leads to the formation of H and OH takes place, addition takes place in accordance with Markovnikov's rule. In accordance with Markovnikov's rule, addition takes place leading to the formation of. So according to Markovnikov's rule, hydrogen of H will go to carbon which contains more number of hydrogen, that is CH2, that leads to CH2, CH, that is CH3, and the negative part of the water, that is OH, will go to CH, that is this. So this will be the major product according to Markovnikov's product, and the minor product is hydrogen going to the carbon of the double bond which contains less number of hydrogen, that is this compound. This is the new hydrogen we have in red, it is shown, and OH will go to the carbon which contains more number of hydrogen, this. So this will be the primary alcohol, which is a minor product, and the major product is this. Let us see how this reaction actually takes place in this reaction. So dilute sulfuric acid is sulfuric acid with water. Whether it is diluted with normally sulfuric acid is 98% sulfuric acid, whereas 2% is only water. So if it is diluted with water, then it is a dilute sulfuric acid, and that acid will contain protonated water, that is H3O plus and HSO4 minus. So this is what the acid is. So H3O plus. Now how does H3O plus react? Let us see that. So this alkene, that is propene, right, will go and approach the hydronium ion, that is H3O plus. This bond opens up. When it opens up, it can open up from this end to take the hydrogen. So that means hydrogen will go to this carbon, that is this. Or this end of the carbon, the double bond will open up like this, and the hydrogen will go to this carbon. So when it opens up, the hydrogen will go here. When this opens up, hydrogen will go there, right? So when this bond opens up like this, the hydrogen will go to the primary, that is CH2. Whereas when this opens up, it goes to the secondary carbon, that is this. So after the formation of it, now here you can see that once the bond opens up, this electron will go to the hydrogen of the proton, the hydrogen or proton of H3O plus. So as a result of that, this electron of the carbon has gone to this, and thereby this carbon loses an electron to become carbonium ion or carbocation. So when this opens up, this electron will go to the hydrogen here, so that is this. So this electron will be from the carbon which is here, so thus this carbon has lost an electron, leading to the formation of primary carbocation. So when the bond opens up, then it leads to this carbocation, that is secondary carbocation. When it opens up like this, it will lead to the primary carbocation. So here the secondary, which is the major product, and minor is primary carbocation. Now after the formation of this, these carbocations react. First, secondary carbocation takes up water, so that is from this water is there, right? So that water will be taken up by the carbocation. So once it is taken up, so this water will be binded to that secondary carbocation, and this is a protonated. And now This is a protonated water or hydroxyl group. Now what happens to neutralize the positive charge? Once the bond forms with this, oxygen will have three bonds. Oxygen can have only have two bonds, right? So the electrons which are present here has given to this to form the bond, right? So electrons, the low pair, two pairs of electrons, out of which one pair has been given to this carbon to form a bond, and thus leading to a protonated OH group. Now to neutralize this, this hydrogen, right, give up this electron. Once it gives up, that will go out as a proton and leading to the formation of OH here on the secondary carbon, and this is secondary alcohol. So that is major product. So that will be the major product. Whereas in other case, this primary carbocation will take up the water. So lone pair of electron will be given to this, and this takes up the OH. So once now water molecule get connected to this carbon atom, so as a result of that, oxygen gets a positive charge, neutralize the positive charge. This hydrogen gives its electron back to oxygen. So one electron of hydrogen, another electron of oxygen comes back and neutralizes the charge, leading to the formation of alcohol, which is a minor product. So this is a primary alcohol, whereas this one is a secondary alcohol. Secondary alcohol will form in major amount, whereas the primary alcohol, that is a secondary alcohol, which is a major. So whereas primary alcohol will be the minor component. So this is what you are going to get. So when alkene, except other than ethene, is made to react with water, that is hydration, it leads to the formation of primary alcohol as well as the secondary alcohol. So in this, primary and secondary alcohol is there in B. So the answer is B for this question. Go to the next question. Next question, which has appeared in KCET 2011. Identify B and D in the following sequence of the reaction, right? And of course, this reaction is quite similar to the previous, that is hydration of alkene. So there, unsymmetrical alkene has been taken, whereas it is asymmetrical, that is ethene, has been taken. So this is made to react with concentrated sulfuric acid. There it was dilute sulfuric acid, whereas here it is concentrated sulfuric acid. Here again, reaction is quite similar to the previous one. There it's water, here it is sulfuric acid itself will be added to the carbon-carbon double bond. You separate one H from here, that is H plus and HSO4 minus, and leading to the formation of the compound A. Compound A on treatment with water gives B. B on treatment with phosphorus tribulmine gives C. C on treatment with the D gives this olefin. So you can get back the olefin from this. So you need to identify what is that B and D. What is the product B and the D which is responsible for the formation of original alkane? So this is quite similar to the previous example. So close this, right? So what happens is when ethene is made to react with concentrated sulfuric acid, it gives ethyl hydrogen sulfate, that is the material. So which on treatment with water, so gives alcohol, and this alcohol treatment with phosphorus tribromide, you will be getting OH will be replaced by Br with the formation of H3PO3 phosphorus acid. So this is what you will get. So from this we have to get the alkene. So we already studied this in part 1, 2, 3 videos, right? So what is this, the compound D, which is responsible for the of this formation of this. So what is that compound is very important. So D is what? That is the question. So D is the one which can remove what? What is that from here to here? What is the difference? Here two hydrogens, here three hydrogens, one hydrogen is different. Here two hydrogen and one Br, one Br is different. So difference is HBr. So this material should remove HBr from this. So what it removes here? Alcoholic KOH is there. Yes, KOH can remove alcoholic KOH, not aqueous KOH. So the compound B is what? So B is 1, 2, 3 B is given here. B is ethyl alcohol, D is ethanol and alcoholic KOH. So this alcoholic KOH can remove that. Once alcoholic KOH is used here, that AOKOH reacts with HBr to give potassium bromide and water. So this is what the reaction is. So ethene on treatment with concentrated sulfuric acid gives ethyl hydrogen sulfate, that is A, which on heating with water gives the alcohol, that is ethyl alcohol or ethanol, and that ethanol on treatment with phosphorus tribromide, it replaces OH by Br, it becomes an alkyl halide. That alkyl halide C is ethyl bromide, and this ethyl bromide on treatment with alcoholic potassium hydroxide, dehydrobromination takes place, leads to the formation of alkene, that is ethene, that is our general compound. So answer is D. Now let us go to the next. The next question is the major product of the following reaction. What is the reaction? So it has appeared in 2020 examination. Oh, okay, it is cyclopropenone, methylated cyclopropenone, right? So when this is heated with acid, H3O plus is nothing but an acid, so that is dilute acid. What is that compound? A is a carbonium ion. Addition of water has taken place here. H3O plus is nothing but hydration of the compound, right? So here hydration is has taken place at C double bond O, right? Okay, that's most important here. Okay, see that, right? Because so this is a protonation. How it happens? Let us say not hydration, sorry, it's a protonation. So carbonium ion and diol is formed here. So it's an alkene diol, and this ketone is remaining there, and OH is getting added to that. That means H and OH is getting added to this carbon-carbon double bond here, to the same carbon OH, and OH has added to this hydrogen to this, right? That's what. So here these two C and D, addition of water, and this is just a protonation of O, and here it is addition of OH water molecule to C double bond O. Let us see how it happens. Reaction is first. Once it is happening, right, so actually the lone pair of electron from here will go to the proton. So once it goes here, this bond opens up. Actually this bond opens up because what will happen is the lone pair of electron actually comes and picks up this to become water. To neutralize the charge, this electron will go over there and generating the carbocation here. So actually lone pair of electron first comes and approaches the acid. Once it approaches the acid, that lone pair of electrons will be neutralized by this, leading to the carbocation here, right? This is what is going to happen. So why this happens here immediately? Why not the other products? Let us see that one by one. So this is, let us see this. This compound is a carbocation. It's a carbocation containing double bond as well as OH, right? So this is a planar compound. In fact, this is also a planar compound because C double bond C and C double bond O, and this is also a planar compound. There is no difference between the planarity of the material, right? So both are planar compounds, right? But the question is, why this is most important here? Both are the same. Why this is most important here? The reason is, this compound contains 4 pi electrons here, 2 pi electrons here. There are 2 pi bonds. One is C double bond O, CC double bond. Here 2 electrons, here 2 electrons, total 4 pi electrons are there. Then how many electrons here? These 2 electrons are already gone to this hydrogen to form OH. So here number of pi electrons are 2 pi electrons. So from 4 pi electrons has been reduced to 2 pi electrons. So what is so special about 2 pi electrons in cyclopropene carbocation? So what is that? Let us see that. So here this molecule is an aromatic molecule. Oh my god, how much is aromatic? Let us see that. So here it is aromatic because it will satisfy 4n plus 2 pi electrons rule. What is that 4n plus 2 pi electrons? Here when n is equal to 0, when n is an integer, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So when n is equal to 0, what will happen? 4 into 0 is 0. 0 plus 2 is 2 pi electrons. If a compound is planar and contains, and it satisfies 4n plus 2 rule, pi electrons rule, then that compound is aromatic. Here it has 2 pi electrons and the carbocation has 2 pi electrons. Hence, this is aromatic. If the compound leading to the formation, if the reaction leading to the formation of aromatic compound, that aromatization will brings out the reaction. That is the driving force for the reactions. Hence, this is the major product, compound A, right? Sorry, species A is a major product in the reaction. So we will be getting cyclopropene, propanol carbocation. So methyl cyclopropanol carbocation is a compound that is will be formed when this cyclopropenone is made to react with the dilute acid, right? So dilute acid, it gives this, right? So the answer is A. The next question is, arrange the following compounds with the increasing order of COH bond length. So we have to find out the length of bond between carbon and hydroxy group present in methanol, phenol, and para-ethoxy-phenol. So methanol, alcohol, this is phenol, and this is also phenol. Let us see the bond length in these compounds, right? Okay. So here, so what is the order? We have to arrange it in the increasing order from lowest to the longest. We have to write. So let us see that one by one. First, let me take the phenol as an example. In this phenol, it is a saturated compound. Though it is unsaturated, it behaves as a saturated compound. It can undergo substitution reaction. This benzene has an electron withdrawing inductive as well as a resonance effect. Because of that, the two pairs of electrons which are there in the oxygen will be under the control of the benzene. These electrons will be pulled by the benzene. Once it is pulled, resonance moment of electron takes place like this. Corner to corner, electrons will move. We'll repeat. Corner to bond, C to B, B to C. Bond to corner moves and leading to the formation of extra electrons here at this carbon that gets negative charge here. Ortho position of phenol, OH will be having negative charge. This bond again moves up back to, moves to this bond, these two single bond, and then it cooks up, cook to this bond and generating extra electrons at the para position. So this is a negative charge at the para position. So that means electrons from here will be delocalized into this carbon, this carbon, this carbon has come up to this point. Again it moves here and this corner, electrons move to this. Corner to bond, bond to corner, electron moves. I will repeat. Corner to bond, bond to corner, electron moves up, generating negative charge here. And this again, corner to bond to corner moves up and neutralize the charge and leading to the original compound. Thereby, this electrons has gone through this benzene molecule and completed the journey, and this will keep happening here in the molecule. As it happens, right, in this process, oxygen will tend to have carbon-oxygen double bond. Here, it tends to have carbon-oxygen double bond. If the bond between the carbon and oxygen, if the number of bonds between the elements increases, the bond length between those two elements decreases. If the double bond here, carbon-oxygen double bond is shorter than carbon-oxygen single bond. So the bond length between carbon and OH here is shorter. So phenol has a shorter bond length. Let us see, right, I can say that it has been shortened because of this resonance effect of the benzene. Because of the resonance effect, bond length has been shortened. So let us see how it is happening with respect to this, how it is happening in para-ethoxyphenol and methanol. So let me take the para ethoxy phenol. So para ethoxy phenol is on the phenol, the at para position ethyl CH3CH2 oxy, that is ethyl oxy or ethoxy. CH3CH2 is ethyl, oxygen ethoxy. So at this position, what is happening is this benzene is pulling the electron and making this oxygen to give the electron towards benzene molecule. So oxygen is tend to give the electron. At the same time, ethyl oxy is a electron releasing group. So this electron releasing group, what they do is it donates the electrons to the oxygen or benzene and to the oxygen. So that means whatever the withdrawal effect which is there from the benzene will be neutralized by the electron releasing impact of this ethoxy group. To certain extent, a resonance effect will be, that is withdrawing effect will be neutralized to certain extent by ethoxy group. As a result of that, the force felt by this oxygen by the benzene is not as same as this, rather the force felt by the oxygen is less than what it will be in case of phenol. So force, that is withdrawing force felt by this oxygen, that is OH of oxygen towards the benzene is less, and thus it will not be under the more pull as that in phenol. So that means carbon oxygen bond in this para-ethoxy phenol is slightly more than that of phenol. So that means the distance between carbon and OH group of the para-ethoxy phenol is slightly more than that of phenol. So that means, so phenol is having lesser bond length than para-ethoxy phenol. Phenol is having less bond length than para-ethoxy phenol. So that is known. Now let us see how it is happening in case of methanol. So methanol is CH3OH. Here, electron withdrawing inductive as well as resonance effect is there in both phenol and ethoxy phenol. Whereas here, CH3 group is an electron releasing group. There is no pull, rather push from this methyl group towards oxygen. There is no electron withdrawing pull towards the carbon of the methyl group. Rather, what is there is, it is a push from the carbon to hydroxy group is there. So that means as a result here, there is no pull. It is only the push, and thus the bond length between carbon and OH, O of the OH of in methanol is longest amongst this set. That means methanol having a longer bond length than CO bond length than paraethoxyphenol, which is longer than phenol. So answer is D is the answer for this. So answer for this is the D. This is the correct answer for this. So only electron releasing effect is there. So only because of that, so this is the answer. So methanol is having longest bond length, whereas the one between carbon and oxygen of the COH, and phenol has the shortest. So paraethoxy is in between. Let us go to the next question. The next question is, the major product B in the following sequences. This is hydroboration reaction. So this is another set of reaction, right? So here this compound is subjected to B2SX. So this is a reagent used for hydroboration of this material, and then this hydrogen peroxide in alkaline media will facilitate the oxidation, then gives place to A, and A on treatment with dilute sulfuric acid gives the compound B, right? Let us see how the reaction takes place. This will be heated with dilute sulfuric acid. This is acid hydrolysis. Let us see how it's happening. Now, first, so these are all the products that begin A, B, C, D, right? We have to find out which one will be the product formed in this case, right? First is hydroboration of this compound. Here, addition of hydrogen to this carbon-carbon double bond takes place in the against the Markovnikov's rule. It is not on par with the Markovnikov's. It is against the Markovnikov's. That is, it is anti-Markovnikov's product. So here, what will happen is from this diborane, right? So from this, one hydrogen will add on to the carbon which contains less number of hydrogen, that is this carbon, and boron will be connected to the CH of this carbon-carbon double bond. So this carbon gets the hydrogen, this carbon which is having more hydrogen will get the boron. So it will be trimer. Three molecules of this combines with BH3, all the three hydrogen will be transferred to this carbon, this carbon-carbon double bond, leading to this addition product. So here, this B2SX is a dimer of BH3. It is a dimer of BH3. In the reaction, BH3 will react. So here, three hydrogens, one hydrogen to each molecule of this olefin will be added to giving rise to this compound. Right? And this compound, on treatment with, this reaction is called as hydroboration. Hydrogen and boron is added to this CC double bond. Hence, it is called as hydroboration reaction. The first step is hydroboration. And then this hydrogen peroxide in alkaline media brings out the oxidation of CB bond. As a result of this, what will happen is B will be replaced by OH. So B is replaced by OH. So now here, addition of water to CC double bond has taken place in total. In nutshell, we can say that addition of water has taken place between carbon and carbon double bond which is present in the compound. Here addition has taken place opposing the Markovnikov's rule. So this is an anti-Markovnikov's product. According to Markovnikov's product, hydrogen should have gone to this CH to give CH2, and OH should have gone to this, but actually OH will go to CH and hydrogen to this. So this is what is going to happen. So this is the product A, the equation. So this is the product of hydroboration. First, hydroboration of this olefin with B2H6, this diborane and hydrogen peroxide in alkaline media, leading to the formation of hydrated compound. Hydrated compound will form, that is A. After this, what they are giving is, they are treating it with a dilute sulfuric acid. This is dehydration reaction. It is a reversal of hydration. It is a removal of hydrate, that is water molecule, from this compound. So water molecule will be removed from this alcohol. So here again, so OH will be protonated by the acid. So once it is protonated, so it will be getting protonated water here, and to neutralize this charge, this electron will migrate. So O has taken up this H. Once it takes up, it will be protonated. Once it is protonated, oxygen will be having three bonds. To neutralize this bond, the bond between carbon and oxygen migrates. Once it migrates, it neutralizes the charge. That means electrons of this carbon will go to this oxygen. So as a result, this charge will be neutralized, positive charge will be neutralized. Once it is neutralized, it will generate a carbocation. It will generate a carbocation. Once it generates a carbocation, so this is the one which is going to form. So this carbon will get the positive charge. Now here, this carbon having the positive charge is connected to one and another one, that is two carbon atoms directly. So this carbocation is a secondary carbocation. This is a secondary carbocation. So So on this carbon, this also connected to two other. This is also secondary carbocation. Now come to this. This is connected to 1, 2, and 3. This is tertiary carbon, and it has a hydrogen. Now what happens is rearrangement takes place. This hydrogen along with the electrons of carbon and this hydrogen will completely shift to this. This we call it as hydride transfer. Hydrogen with extra electron of carbon will be shifted to this. That means this carbon loses electron to this carbon and also this hydrogen. Once it loses, this hydrogen along with the electron of carbon goes over here and forms this bond. And thereby, the positive charge of this carbon will be shifted to this. So this becomes a positively charged carbon, that is a carbocation. Here, this carbon containing positive charge is connected to 1, 2 and 3. That is, this is tertiary carbocation. Earlier it was secondary, now it is tertiary carbocation. So this is more stabler than the secondary carbocation. Hence, this will form. Now what should happen? The positive charge on the carbon has to be neutralized. To neutralize that, the hydrogen present on this isopropyl group, this carbon having hydrogen here, this hydrogen along with this electron of carbon as well as electron of hydrogen will be migrated to this. Once it migrates, electrons of carbon as will be, hydrogen will also be given to this, and hydrogen goes out as H plus. It will go out as a H plus, and as a result of that, there will be a double bond between this carbon and this carbon. This leads to the formation of alkene. So double bond will form here. Once it forms, look at this. This CC double bond contains 1 methyl group, 2 methyl group and a 3 methyl group. So here, if at all the double bond is formed here at this point, it would have contained this isopropyl group here, methyl group here and ethyl group here, right? So one is methyl, other one is isopropyl group and ethyl group. But if the hydride transfers to this, carbocation will form here and leading to this. And this is a sedge of product. Here this is contains highly substituted alkane. Here also this would have been substituted alkane. One is methyl, isopropyl and ethyl. Whereas in this case, all the group, majority of the groups are methyl, methyl, methyl. So this is also electron releasing, this is also electron releasing, this is also electron releasing. Of course, these are also methyl, isopropyl and ethyl. But along with that, this CH3 groups can contribute to the stability of the carbon-carbon double bond by hyperconjugation. So that can stabilize this carbon-carbon double bond by hyperconjugation, and this is highly substituted sedge of product, and it is being stabilized by hyperconjugation. Hence, this product carbon containing double bond between isopropyl and normal butyl chain, isobutyl chains will form, and thus this will be the product that is going to happen. So form. So this is the bond structure of this compound, right? So this is what C double bond C. This is the one methyl group. That is this. This methyl groups, two methyl groups, that is these two are shown here. Then in the normal propyl group 1, 2, 3. So this is the product. The compound D is the answer for this question. So this is one of the important question, right? So this is hydroboration method, and this is the method for the preparation of alcohols also. Here in this method, you will be getting normally the product against the Markovnikov. So anti-Markovnikov products will form. Normally by hydration process, Markovnikov's product will form, whereas by hydroboration process, here also it looks like it is addition of H and OH, water molecule will be added to the carbon-carbon double bond, but the product is anti-Markovnikov's product. That is a major difference between hydration of olefins and hydroboration leading to hydroboration followed by oxidation to give the alcohols, right? So both are hydration process in nutshell, both are hydroboration, but the products formed are different. So next, let us go to the next question. You should know the difference between the hydroboration alcohols obtained by this and also by the hydration of alkenes. Next question is the major product of the following reaction. What is that major product? Let us see that. So it has appeared in JEE 2019, yours, lithium aluminum hydride. This is one of the important question that is the arbolivine asked many a times in the examination. CH3, CH double bond, CH, CH2, COO, CH3, ester, unsaturated ester is made to react with lithium aluminum hydride. So here we need to know the behavior of the strong reducing agents that are used in the process of getting the alcohols. Majority of the alcohols are obtained by the reduction phenomenon. So the reagents that are being used and the starting material are the substrates are. So when aldehyde is used, right, the reagents that could be used as lithium aluminum hydride, sodium borohydride or hydrogen with palladium supported on carbon, palladized carbon. So in all these case, aldehydes use primary alcohols. Remember this, aldehydes will give primary alcohols with all these reducing agents, either this or sodium borohydride, lithium aluminum hydride or hydrogen, that is catalytic hydrogenation. If you treat with RCOR dash, this is ketone, RCOR dash, lithium aluminum hydride, all these reducing agents use secondary alcohols. Carbon containing hydroxy group is connected to one carbon, another carbon, it's a secondary alcohol. Ketones give secondary alcohols, aldehydes use primary alcohol, this we should remember. And next thing is acid and esters on reduction using lithium aluminum hydride, both will give primary alcohols. Remember, acids as well as ester will give primary alcohol. RCOO group will give RCH2OH, whereas R dash group will come out as R dash OH, which is also alcohol. Right, so there are two alcohols obtained here in case of esters. Right, so the product which has been obtained in this case is, here these are all the reducing agents which can be used. Right, so this and the, if you use lithium aluminum hydride, it can reduce only the ester but not carbon carbon double bond. It can reduce only this ester units to give alcohol. Alcohol is the compound that is going to form. So by the reduction of this ester with lithium aluminum hydride, so you have to get this with this alcohol by retaining the double bond. So double bond is retained in this case only, so this contains primary alcohol, so that is the answer. So answer is C. So remember this reducing agents and the substrates with and the products, these are the products. Next question is appeared in JEE 2014, the reaction. Okay, acid reacting with lithium aluminum hydride. Just now you know what is that acid will give with lithium aluminum hydride. This reacts with phosphorus pentachloride to give this we have studied under alcohols, preparation of alkyl halides. Alkyl, this is a very important method from the alcohols, right? Okay, to give B, and B on treatment with alcoholic potassium hydroxide, this also we have studied under alkyl halides. So PCl5 and reaction of alcoholic KOH was studied under that to give C. What is the compound that we are going to get? So here the clue is, you already know the role of this, right, in the previous example, right? What is that? Lithium aluminum hydride behavior is already known. You know this. So this will convert acid into alcohol. Alcohol on treatment with this, right? So here alcohol is there, then treatment with phosphorus pentabromide gives alkyl halide. So our role of PBr3 is similar to PCl5. PCl5 and PCl3 or PBr3 almost the same, right? It will replace OH by the halogen which is present there. So halogen irritated compound is formed, and that compound on treatment with alcoholic KOH. Alcoholic KOH is dehydrohalogenation. You have seen this in the previous example, right? So it will bring out the removal of halogen from the compound B, leading to the formation of the compound, right? What is that we are going to get? This leads to the formation of this alcohol that I have already told. So A will give the alcohol. This alcohol on treatment with alkyl halide, phosphorus pentachloride gives the compound as halo compound alcohol, that is CH3COOH, CH3OH, and then CH3Cl, CH3CH2OH, this is acetyl alcohol. Then CH3CH2Cl and CH3CH2Cl undergoes dehydrogenation to give the alkene. Alkene is ethene or ethylene. Ethylene is the answer, right? So let us see the reaction. This is very again reduced with lithium aluminum hydride. What the compound obtained will be when CH2 double bond CH treated with acid, that is acid is treated with lithium aluminum hydride. What is the product? So this COOH becomes alcohol. That's it. No change in the double bond. So double bond is here. CH2OH is there. So this is the answer, right? That we know. And the following sequence reaction: CH3Br, KCN, okay. So role of Gr and KCN is very simple, right? So here what it does is it can replace alkyl halide reaction of with alcoholic potassium cyanide is known. It can replace Br by CN. And one thing which you have to know here is cyano group on treatment with acids that will be converted to that is in presence of dilute acids, A will be converted to carboxylic acid. That's it. Cyano group will be converted to carboxylic acid. So you have a carboxylic acid here, and then it is made to react with lithium aluminium hydride. So R group remains there. Thus Br will be converted to CN. CN is converted to COOH. COOH will be converted to CH2OH. So compound which you are going to get at the end is alcohol. So know what that alcohol is, right? So these are all the homeworks, right? You do again, right? Next question. The question is the major product of the following reaction is okay. This is again sodium borohydride. Here C double bond O is there. Here CC double bond is there. C double bond N and N methylated. This CH3 is connected to C double bond N, right? So this sodium borohydride can reduce C double bond O as well as C double bond N. That's it. So that is what it is. So both will be get reduced. Addition of hydrogen takes place across these two carbon oxygen double bond and carbon nitrogen double bond, leading to the formation of saturated bonds here, that single bond here as well as this. So here O becomes OH, here CH2 NH. So that is what the compound is. You note down the product that is going to obtain. So a stronger reducing it, that reduces CO and CN, COO and CN, but cannot reduce C double bond. Next one, preparation of alcohols using Grignard reagent. This is very important reaction. When an Grignard reagent or MGX, this is a general way of representing Grignard reagent. So when Grignard reagent is made to react with HC double bond OH, this is formaldehyde. Mind you, this aldehyde unit, this compound can give alcohol. Look at the red color of the compound. This block is from the Grignard reagent. Grignard reagent here, R is negatively charged, that is carbon anion. That carbon ion will go to the electron deficient center, carbon plus here in the aldehyde. R minus will go to C plus, forms a bond between R and C. This bond opens up. O minus will take this magnesium to give magnesium hydroxide, right? And magnesium halide, sorry. Oxy, magnesium halide, right? So here, so double bond becomes single bond. This R is from Grignard reagent. This CH2O is from the aldehyde, that is formaldehyde. And then this has hydrolysis using dilute sulfuric acid. Addition of water takes place. H will go to O of the alkyl group. OH will go to MgOOX, giving this to magnesium hydroxy X. And then H will come here. CH2OH will be from CH2O, that is formaldehyde. Always the CH2OH, that is a component of primary alcohol, right? Okay, the carbon containing OH is connected to two other hydrogen atoms and only one carbon, that is a primary alcohol. So this will be obtained. So example I have taken, it is methyl magnesium iodide made to react with H, C double bond OH, that is formaldehyde, giving rise to hydroxy compound, and this on hydrolysis gives. So this here takes place, bond breakage takes, hydrolysis takes place here. O gets hydrogen, MgI gets OH. So magnesium hydroxide will be separated. You will be getting CH3. This CH2OH is from this aldehyde. That means formaldehyde will always gives primary alcohol. Remember this. So as to get the primary alcohol, one of the aldehyde that has to be made to react with the Grignard reagent is formaldehyde. To get primary alcohol, you should start with formaldehyde always gives primary alcohol, right? Similarly, secondary alcohol, preparation of secondary alcohol, RMGX with R dash C double bond OH other than formaldehyde. If one of the hydrogen is R dash group, another group, other group, then R minus will go here. R minus has formed a bond with carbon, so this R dash of the aldehyde is remaining here. So here hydrogen, both on the either side, hydrogen was there. Here one alkyl group, other one is hydrogen. This is from the aldehyde, right? And this leads to OMGX halide, right? Intermediate, and this are hydrolysis gives. OH will go to this, OH will be to this, leading to the formation of MG hydroxy. So here So this carbon is connected, this OH containing carbon connected to one R from the aldehyde, another R from the Grignard reagent, and this C connected to two other carbon atoms, hence it is a secondary alcohol. Similarly, so example is same, CH3MG is taken, here also CH3CHO, that is acetaldehyde, is taken, CH3CH3OMGI is formed, this on hydrolysis, leading to H will go here, OH will be taken to MGY, leading to CH3CCH3OH, OH containing carbon connected to 1 and 2, secondary alcohol, this is isopropyl alcohol, this is secondary. So other aldehydes, other than formaldehyde, will always give secondary alcohol. So these are all the general means of preparing the alcohols, primary or secondary. Now let us see the next one. If instead of aldehydes, if you take ketones, if you have taken ketones, RMGX is Grignard reagent, is made to react with R dash C double bond O R2 dash, here R minus will go and approach the C plus of the ketone, leading to the formation of bond between R and C plus of ketone, leading to CO MGX bond, and this on hydrolysis, hydrogen will go to O of the CO, hydroxy will go to MGX, leading to Mg hydroxy X, magnesium hydroxy halide, and C becomes OH. This carbon containing OH is connected to 1, 2, 3 carbon atoms, hence it is a tertiary alcohol. So example is CH3MGI with CH3COCH3, that is a stone, leading to this intermediate, this on hydrolysis with CH3CCH3 twice OH. So that will be tertiary alcohol. So tertiary alcohol will be obtained by this reaction. So this is what is happening here, right? So this will be CH3, sorry. Now next is, here always ketones gives tertiary alcohols. Ketones gives tertiary alcohol. Now let us see the once again. If you get, if you want to get CH2OH, that is primary alcohol, always you have to start with formaldehyde. That is, if you get the primary alcohols, always start with formaldehyde, and depending upon the R group, you get the corresponding alcohol. To get a secondary alcohol, start with aldehyde other than formaldehyde. Other than formaldehyde, if you start, you will be getting secondary alcohol. To get tertiary alcohol, that is the aldehyde. To get the tertiary alcohol, so you have to start with ketone. Right? Ketones will always give tertiary alcohols. So these are the methods of preparing primary, secondary, and tertiary alcohols. So this is very, very important reaction, so as to get the corresponding respective alcohols. So one of the method to get the alcohols from this compound is this, right? So next question. The next question is, which of the following combinations can be used to prepare ethanol? Okay. This is an aldehyde actually. Anyway, since it is a Grignard reaction, right? Okay, this is not ethanol, NOL, it is NAL, right? So, which one is a good method? Okay, let us see this. This, because formaldehyde I was telling you, right? So, let us see which one is good, right? Here, in this case, Grignard reagent is there. This is ethyl acetate, this is acetone, this is ethyl alcohol, this is ethyl formate. So, I have taken aldehyde there. Aldehyde or ketone. So only thing is, here this is a ketone, whereas other compounds are not ketones, right? So this ketone, you know, it is always leads to the formation of tertiary alcohol. So C is ruled out. Grignard reagent with ketone will always give tertiary alcohol, whereas ethanol is CH3CHO. It is an acetald. It is nothing but acetaldehyde. Now let us see how, which one will give, right? So here the best method is methyl magnesium iodide with ethyl. This is ethyl group connected to formate. This is ethyl formate. So when it is made to react with ethyl formate, negative part of it will go here. This becomes O minus, right? And this will be O MGI. Then what happens, when you hydrolyze this, this bond will migrate and this will be cleaved, because OC2H5 is a better living group than this. So it will be cleaved very easily when you hydrolyze this, and on the other hand, this will be easily taken out by this MGI to you, ethoxy magnesium iodide, and as a result of that, C double bond O will form, leading to aldehyde, CH3C double bond O H, that is acetaldehyde, which is nothing but ethanol. Since it is away from the previous example taken up here, right, of course it is not part of this chapter. Next question. So this shows that following alcohol, okay, show how are the following alcohols prepared by the reactions of suitable reagent. Okay, how they are being prepared. Okay, this, yeah, very important question. This is a homework for you. Has to do that, right? So you have to get compound A 1 and 2. So this has to be obtained from the suitable reagents. Of course, this is different. And here, tell us which one is the suitable material for to get A for compound 1 and compound 2. So best combination to do, which one is doing, you have to tell that. Ketone is there, here CH3, CH2, CH2, MgBr is there. Of course, this is a formaldehyde. So this will be a methyl alcohol, CH2OH. CH2OH will always obtain from the formaldehyde. So here also CH2OH, this also to be obtained from formaldehyde. So if you look for the formaldehyde, so this you are moiety from the formaldehyde. Here also CH2OH is going to formaldehyde, whereas this will be from the Grignard reagent, and here again this part will be from the Grignard reagent. Grignard reagent will be from this CH3CH, CH3. Okay, this is the part of it. This is isopropyl group and this is cyclohexyl group. So which one is that? You find out, right? Okay, here C6H11 is nothing but here it is C6H12 is XII. XII is one hydrogen less. So C6H12 XII group. So find out the suitable group for the preparation of this. So this is the in-text question from book, right? So this is a very important question. Next question is the correct sequence of the reagent for the following conversions will be, okay, this is again, okay, one side, okay, so this is a cyclohexyl group, one side is ketone, cyclohexanone, this is aldehyde. So here what is happening, this aldehyde is getting connected to OH, connected to two other carbon atoms. Okay, this two is connected, becoming alcohol, right? So this is an alcohol, so it is becoming a secondary alcohol. Of course, it's already aldehyde, right? So this is not a formaldehyde, always formaldehyde, other than formaldehyde, when it is made to react with the Grignard reagent, it gives secondary alcohol, you know that. Other than formaldehyde, when aldehyde is made to react with what the reagent, right, you will be getting secondary alcohol. But here there are two CH3 group, that is most important. Here one is hydrogen, this is cyclohexyl group, so this is very tricky. And this will be CH3Mg. Okay, this is very simple reaction of all Grignard reagent. Let us see this. Very important. Which one is that? So first one is, okay, this AgNH3 twice, ammoniacal silver nitrate. This part is an ammoniacal silver nitrate. This is nothing but tollens reagent. Ammoniacal silver nitrate, AgNH3 twice plus OH minus, this is ammoniacal silver nitrate. This is, and this is methanol, the imbalance of acid. Okay, this is esterification. It's H plus, and alcohol with H plus is esterification. Reagent used for esterification. This is Grignard reagent. Here Grignard reagent, esterification reagent, tollens reagent, Grignard reagent, tollens reagent and esterification. Tollens reagent, Grignard reagent and esterification. Which one is the correct one, right? So this is a very good question, right? Next question. Oh, denatured alcohol is, what is the denatured alcohol? Rectified spirit, no. Undistilled alcohol, no. Rectified spirit with methanol and naphtha. Wood naphtha, actually methanol itself is wood naphtha. Plus pyridine will also be there here, right? Actually, this is it. So naphtha, that is wood naphtha, rectified spirit, and also to a certain extent, the naphtha will be, pyridine will be present here, right? So this is what the rectified, denatured alcohol is. Now, the answer. Dear friends, this is the time for you to ask questions. Please feel free to ask questions, don't have any inhibitions. So please like this video, share with your friends and subscribe to my channels. Thank you very much. This has been a nice time with you. Please let me know if you have any questions. Wish you all the best. Thank you very much.